Welcome to this video presentation of the placement of resin dental sealants, specifically by school dental sealant programs. This video is intended for the professionals placing the sealants and for those who assist with the procedure. Programs should always follow the manufacturer's guidelines for the specific sealant material they use. This video demonstrates the use of Clinpro Unfilled sealant material. School dental sealant programs should use a sealant material that is less than 10% filled so the sealant will self-adjust. Materials over 10% filled may require adjustment with a handpiece, and that handpiece must then be sterilized. There is no statistically significant difference in the effectiveness or retention of filled versus unfilled sealant material. Note that the main cause of sealant failure is saliva contamination. Saliva is not to contact the tooth surface from the beginning of the procedure until the end. That means the provider must ensure there is adequate isolation, that the tooth is dried before the etchant, re-isolated and dried before the sealant, and that the patient is not allowed to swallow or to close at any time during the procedure. You first want to check the air water syringe to ensure there is no moisture coming through the air line. Just spray air on the mirror or on the patient's bib until you can be sure the air line is completely clear. Select the teeth to be sealed. Screening only can be conducted with one gloved hand if the ungloved hand does not touch the patient. Once the patient's situation is assessed, preparation for sealants can begin. The occlusals of the teeth must first be thoroughly cleaned with a toothbrush. The provider must then check the surface for cleanliness by using an explorer appropriately, as recommended by the American Dental Association. In other words, use the explorer to check gently the cleanliness or texture of the tooth without scratching or damaging the tooth surface. Prior to etching, isolate the tooth and dry the occlusal surface. Some research suggests drying for 20 seconds. The point is that the tooth must be thoroughly dried before etching. Then apply a generous amount of etchant. The etchant is to extend 2 to 3 millimeters past the intended margin of the sealant. Don't skip on the etchant. Notice how much etchant is used on the Clinpro application video. Apply the etchant and gently and continually tap the etchant down into the pits and grooves of the occlusal surface for at least 20 seconds to ensure the etchant contacts the deepest areas. Etchant is often viscous and may just sit on the surface, leaving unintended voids underneath. Tap the etchant down into the tooth gently, but don't scratch it in, as that can damage the tooth surface. Rinse off the etchant thoroughly. Remove excess water. Then re-isolate. You can do this by either adding a cotton roll, if that's comfortable for your patient, or you can add a cotton roll and then use forceps to slip out the old wet cotton roll from underneath. Do not allow saliva contamination when re-isolating. When the tooth is securely re-isolated, dry thoroughly. The surface should have a dull, frosty appearance. Then place the sealant. Sealant material should be placed in all vulnerable grooves and pits, occlusals, buccals, and linguals. Occlusals are the most common surfaces to decay, but buccals and linguals are the second most common, even decaying more often than interproximal surfaces. Make the most of this opportunity to protect all accessible surfaces. Run the sealant tip through the sealant to remove voids or bubbles. If necessary, remove excess sealant material with a sponge tip applicator. An overfilled sealant is more likely to be lost due to constant occlusal interference. Cure the sealant for as long as recommended by the cure light manufacturer, as the recommended times may vary. Use a cure light meter periodically to test the intensity of your curing light. Several curing light meters are available at a reasonable cost. The older halogen lights require a greater length of curing time compared to the newer LED rechargeable lights. After curing, use an explorer to evaluate the sealant for retention. Remove any residual flashing. Check for bubbles. It is really only necessary to add sealant material if the bubbles are at the margin of the sealant. Brush with a smear of toothpaste to remove the bisphenol A. Even though the sealant manufacturer may list only bis-GMA or DMA as ingredients, the American Dental Association says that BPA is still likely to be present in trace amounts. Using a smear of toothpaste will also remove any residual bad taste for your patient. Note that this is not adequate isolation. In the first photo, the tongue is not adequately blocked. In the second photo, the cheek will surely wick saliva onto the tooth. In the third photo, the glove will wick saliva, so ensure a cotton roll is between the glove and the tooth. And in the fourth photo, there is a need for a cotton roll or dry aid on the cheek side. This is one way to isolate tooth number 3, with the hygienist holding the dry aid with a mirror and the assistant using the saliva ejector or a HYVAC to block the tongue. There's no need to press on the tongue. Just ask the child not to touch the suction with her tongue. There are a couple options for tooth number 14, the most difficult tooth to seal. Have the assistant hold the dry aid and the suction inside the cheek, where there's often not enough room. Or have the assistant hold the suction up and over, coming in from the patient's right side, out of the hygienist's line of sight, but also blocking the tongue. For tooth number 19, the hygienist holds the lingual cotton roll, the assistant the buccal cotton roll. As for all sealants, the suction should remain in the mouth as often as possible, and ideally, the lower lip should be retracted to increase the field of vision. In conclusion, remember that the most common cause of sealant failure is saliva contamination at any time from the beginning of the procedure to the end. We hope this video was useful for you as you move forward to provide this very important preventive service in the schools.